Most common fractures are definitely wrist and forearm trauma, falls from playing sports or on playground equipment or bicycles. Fractures, especially near the wrist, but also in the forearm, are the most common things that we treat. We definitely see fractures more often than sprains, and that's due to their physiology, as their bones are softer and weaker than their ligaments are. So typically, children will fracture things before they sprain. There are exceptions. You know, as you get into adolescent, you get more of an adult type skeleton, then especially around the ankle, sprains can be more common. So I tell families all the time, and I've had several mothers that I've talked with about this, that if a child falls and injures something, first I just recommend bringing them inside, icing it, give them Motrin, and see how they do. Unless there's a severe deformity or something like that, a lot of times these things can be taken care of the next day or after the weekend, and there's usually not a huge need to rush to the emergency room unless there is severe deformity or intractable pain that they're not able to take care of. And we can take care of a lot of this in the outpatient setting. And frequently, patients will go to the emergency room on Saturday, and then we'll be seeing them Monday for follow-up anyways. And if they can just make it through Monday, they can skip the ER visit. There's no penalty for delaying care on that front. Unless you get out to weeks, then there can be. But a day or two, no, there's no penalty for that. And oftentimes with families presenting to ERs that are not familiar with children's fractures, they'll just get splinted and sent to us for management anyways. The story can be quite confusing because they're seeing people who aren't used to taking care of children, and they show up to the office and they don't even know if it's broken or not, but they're splinted, and that's often that all that occurs during that ER visit. Surgical fractures are fractures that have significant deformity or in older children or at a particular location near the growth plate. But again, very frequently these can be taken care of on an outpatient basis, especially in this COVID environment. People are wanting to stay out of hospitals, not sit up there around a bunch of sick people. We can have you sleep in your own bed and take care of this in a scheduled manner, because everybody's schedules are so busy that we can plan to do this rather than stay up all night in the hospital taking care of these things. We can take care of them in a more convenient manner. So will children who break or fracture their arm or leg or whatever be more likely to fracture again? Yes and no. When the bone heals, it's stronger than it was before it was fractured. However, kids who fracture things are usually kids who are having fun and doing fun things. They don't fracture things by playing video games. And so kids that are out there having fun are more likely to break something again. So we do see it. Now, early on in fracture healing process, yes, you're more likely to fracture it again, which is why we do the cast and things like that and activity restrictions. But long term, no, kids aren't more likely to break again the same bone that they had previously fractured. So we did a research study looking at children undergoing outpatient surgery. We looked at 3,780 patients getting outpatient surgery for various things, whether it was trauma or whether it was ACL surgery or deformity surgery. Out of that group of almost 4,000 kids, we had three patients that needed a transfer to the hospital, and all of them did great while doing so, mostly asthma-related, airway issues, and things like that. Outside of those kids being transferred to the hospital, everybody else did fantastic. So it was very safe to do surgery in the outpatient setting.